Santander Arena Spotlight on BCTV is underwritten by the Berks County Convention Center Authority.
Hello and welcome to the Santander Arena Spotlight. I'm Michael Fiucci, Berks County Convention Center Authority member, and tonight I have two guests with me. To my immediate right, Drew Bell, General Manager of the Reading Royals. Welcome, Drew.
Thanks, Mike. Thanks for having me back.
And Dave Farrar, our General Manager for the Santander Arena. And welcome again, Dave.
Thanks, Mike. Thanks for having me.
Yes. Appreciate you guys coming tonight.
Absolutely.
A little rainy night out there, but at least it's not snowing this time of year, so that's always a good thing.
I'll talk hockey on any night.
That's right. But hockey's always good on a colder night, so.
It is. The colder, the better.
That's right. So, before we get into new stuff, I want to recap the opening night for the Reading Royals. It's probably one of the nicest, most exciting opening nights we've had in years. Out of 15 years, I've been to 14 of them, and that was a great opening night. So, yeah. Drew, you want to elaborate on that? It was a great night, and it was an exciting night.
It was crazy. It was a full day of events, thanks to Santander Arena, Downtown Improvement District, Berks County Community Foundation. We kicked the night off with a free Gin Blossoms concert on Penn Avenue, and the block was packed.
Yeah.
I think it really worked out well acoustically too, with the hotel and the Santander Arena. It was mobbed as far as back as I could see. I introduced Heidi Williamson from BCCF. It was a little intimidating, but to see that many people out to enjoy some free music and opening night for the Royals, it really couldn't have been much better. We had a packed house. We had the first sellout in, I think, 4 or 5 years at the Santander Arena. We had some nice pyrotechnics and intro lighting, thanks to Illusion and Sound, U.S. Illusion and Sound. Unfortunately, we couldn't pull out the win for the night. It tends to be a little bit of a jinx for us when we get a pretty full house. We can't pull out the win.
Seems to happen when we get a sellout or a big crowd. We don't seem to win on those.
The guys come out under pressure. They want to do well for the hometown crowd. You know, we got a lot of young guys on this team this year, and I think getting out there and seeing how rabid our fans are might have been a little intimidating for them. But after that, we strung a couple of wins together, which helped, and we need them right now more than ever.
Yeah, so. Yeah, a lot of call-ups lately and stuff like that, a lot of injuries. So.
Yeah, we've been the whole affiliation system right now has just been devastated by injuries.
Yeah.
You look at the Flyers right now, I think they've got 8 guys that are scratched on a nightly basis with injuries. You look in Lehigh Valley, and they've got injuries with a goaltender almost every other week. And, they've got forward injuries, defensive injuries, and unfortunately when you're at the bottom of the pecking order in an affiliation system, you're losing a guy every time somebody gets injured, either at the AHL or the big show level. So it's been a tough storm to weather, but we actually just made a big acquisition today. We traded for a guy out of Orlando, a guy named Scott. He's a great guy, good leader, energy guy, should provide some good depth for us. So we're excited to have him in town.
So that's a good... think for our viewers out there that are Royals fans that we're hearing that here tonight, that new acquisition.
Scott Tansky, he's a great guy. He's a good community guy. I know the fans in Orlando are pretty upset to see him go, and I can understand that. I'm hoping he kind of fills in a role of an Olivier Labelle, David Marshall type guy. Maybe not the same scoring prowess that those two guys had, but the energy, tempo, hard hitting. And he'll also fill a hole, I think, that's been left since Ryan Crothers left in the community. Everything I've heard about him and read about him, he's a really big community guy. He gets involved. He volunteers his time. So we're excited to bring him on board.
Good. We look forward to seeing him.
Yeah.
Guess it won't be a while till we have a game at the Sovereign Center after a bunch of games in November. So
yeah, we were home almost 18th. The entire month of November, and I think my family might be happy that we don't have a game for 3 weekends.
Give
now
a little break.
I actually get to see my family and help out my wife a little bit. But we've got 2 great games coming up on the 18th and 19th of December. The 18th, we're giving away a pretzel ornament thanks to Toys for Tots.
Okay,
it's also our ugly sweater Christmas jersey that we wear. We become a little bit famous for it over the last couple of years.
Internet the one year, it was all over the internet.
It's all over. ESPN picked it up. Yahoo Sports picked it up. So we've kind of become a little bit notorious for that. And then on the 19th, both games are against the Elmira Jackals, one of our biggest rivals.
Yep.
The 19th will be our Pucks for Paws night. We're going to be wearing specialty jersey, auctioning them off to help support the Humane Society of Berks County. We'll also be raising money for John Paul II Learning Center.
Okay, good.
What else do we have that night? We've got Teddy Bear Toss.
Teddy Bear Toss.
That's a favorite with everybody.
Yeah, that's
right?
Always a popular night.
So after we score our first goal, everybody's encouraged to bring a stuffed animal out. We score a goal, throw it on the ice. It's one of the only times I'll let people throw anything on the ice, unless you're one of my coaches. Bring them out. I think last night in Bakersfield, they had like something like 7,900 animals that were collected. And it all gets collected for Toys for Tots, given to kids in hospitals and less fortunate kids. So it's a great cause. Get some teddy bears, bring them out, cheer us on, and let's raise some money for Humane Society and John Paul, too.
Absolutely. Some good nights coming up there.
Yeah, for sure.
Looking forward to that.
Yeah.
Dave, we got a lot of stuff coming up with the holidays here. We got a lot of stuff coming up. It's a packed time for us. It's really good to see this stuff coming into the arena. Something for everyone. Do you want to go over some of the holiday stuff, and then we'll go into the new stuff for the new year?
Yeah, absolutely. We're definitely busy. We just had one night of two shows with Trans-Siberian Orchestra the day before Thanksgiving that was well attended, so that was nice to have a big crowd out for that and the support of Reading and the surrounding counties. So we'll go to the PowerPoint here. We've got a bunch of upcoming events if we can. Obviously right there you can see our website, santander-arena.com. Anything that you want to find out about upcoming events, please visit that.
Next up, looks good, Dave. We had a few technical difficulties there earlier, so
it does look good.
Smoothly. Looks real good.
After a few technical difficulties, we got it. But
look out for King Kong.
Yeah, so coming up, we've got Lewis Black. Let me go back to that. Lewis Black here, Grammy Award-winning comedian. He's been to town before. He performs over 200 nights a year, so he's a busy act, and we're excited to have him come back to Reading. That show's Thursday night, doing very well, and as you can see from the picture there, he's a little out there.
He's a little nuts. I saw him New Year's Eve in like 2000. He was crazy then.
Yeah, it should be a fun night. And then Thursday night over at the arena, we have Straight No Chaser, which is a group that's been here two or three times.
And they usually draw pretty well. I was at one of their... They do a good crowd. They have a good following.
Yep, and it's in our cut-down arena, the Reading Eagle Theater. It's a 10-guy a cappella group. Nothing on stage but some lights and 10 guys making incredible sound, and they'll cover all the top 40 hits and just a good night all around. After that, we've got something for the kids. We've got Peppa Pig, which is the top-rated show on Nick Jr. right now. Yeah, tickets for that start at $29.50. And that's selling.
If you want the theme song, I can recite it right now by heart.
I'm sure. Yeah.
if you have kids and you've heard the song once, you can sing it for days. After that, we've got K-Love Christmas on Saturday over at the arena. A bunch of Christian artists. 10th Avenue North, Sidewalk Prophets, Danny Gokey from American Idol, and Natalie Grant. Saturday night, we also have John Prine that's actually doing very well. One of the best songwriters ever and selling tickets. And he's been to town before, so it's exciting to have him back after a few years off. And then we're going to wrap it up on Sunday with Mercy Me, a Christian group that's had a hit not only on Christian radio, but also in the top 40 with a song I can only imagine that I'm sure everyone has heard at least once. It's going to go for me there. Wednesday, we have the Punch Brothers come in with Chris Style from Nickel Creek. Chris is actually going to take over for Garrison Keillor next year on Garrison Keillor's Prairie Home Companion.
Okay.
So excited to have those guys come to town. And then going off of TSO, we have Mannheim Steamroller coming next Friday night, which is exciting to have
Christmas
back.
Another good Christmas event.
Selling very well, so let's get your tickets soon, because it'll hopefully be sold out here in the next couple of days. And then Sinatra Forever, on Frank Sinatra's 100th birthday, we're going to have a guy named Rick Michael sing Sinatra songs all night with a full 30-piece orchestra, and looking forward to that show to celebrate Frank's 100th birthday.
Nice.
After that, we have Jason Bonham's Led Zeppelin Experience for all the Zeppelin fans out there. He comes with a big video screen and plays drums to all the Zeppelin hits over the years. So it's an exciting one for us and a really cool show. And then every spring we have Winter Jam come to town with the big Christian show. It's a free show. They do ask for donations at the door, but it's a lineup and get in. This year we've got For King and Country, David Crowder, which is a big one, and Matthew West. And then they'll do a total of about 12 bands, which is an exciting night.
That's always well attended. There's a lot of people that look forward to that night.
Yep. After that, we've got Joe Bonamassa coming back to town for a special acoustic evening on January 12th. The Machine performs Pink Floyd will be back in town on January 16th. A viewing of The Karate Kid, the first original Karate Kid with an actual question and answer and meet and greet with Ralph Macchio, which will be pretty cool. So bring out the kids, introduce them to The Karate Kid. After that, the Australian Bee Gees on January 24th. The kids again, Daniel Tiger's coming to town here on January 31st, which is a Sunday for two shows. Star Trek The Ultimate Voyage is coming out in February. They're going to do a national tour. It'll be a 30-piece symphony orchestra along with some videos of Star Wars. So really cool event for anyone who's a Star Trek. Anyone who's a Star Trek fan.
That's a good timing for that with the Star Wars coming out. And
yep. Paula Poundstone, comedian, will be here on February 12th. Daryl Hall and John Oates will play over in the arena on February 16th. That's a big show for us in the Red Eagle Theater. Get the Let Out's coming for two nights this year after selling out one last year, February 19th and 20th. It's a Friday and Saturday. That'll be a big weekend. And then A Night with Janis Joplin, which is a new musical straight from Broadway, March 1st. R5, which is kind of a pop top 40 act, coming to town March 7th. They were here about a year and a half ago. And then the Globetrotters will come back for their yearly play, which will be a great night for the family, March 8th. Jason Bishop, who's a local illusionist, is coming back to town. He was here about 2 years ago. That's on Friday, March 11th. Disney on Ice will be here for six performances, March 17th through 20th.
Wow.
Good to have Disney back for the first time in a couple years.
What's their theme this year, Dave?
Let's celebrate. So it's going to be a little bit of everything.
Okay.
A little bit of Frozen, a little bit of Aladdin.
You need to hold some tickets for me for that, buddy.
Yeah. Anything Frozen will go good.
Anything Frozen does well. And then we're excited to bring Tracy Morgan to town on Saturday, April 23rd.
Okay.
He obviously had a big accident down in Atlantic City last year, and excited to see him back up on his feet and doing some stand-up. So that's a big one for us to bring to town.
Saturday, I already have my tickets for that one.
Yep, that'll be good. Then Alton Brown's coming to town. This show's selling very well and should sell out pretty quickly. So Friday, April 29th, Alton will be in town. Clint Black, so we'll do a little country here in May.
Okay.
Thursday night, May 12th. Clint's coming with his full band, and he'll do all the hits. And then Jeannie Robertson, comedian, coming in September. So we're already booking the fall.
Already September.
We're already way ahead of things with the fall. So starting to announce some stuff slowly there. I think that's it. So again, the website's on there. Our Twitter's on there. Facebook. All the social media sites, you can find out what we have going on. We're busy and we're excited and happy to bring some of these artists to town.
This is a good schedule, especially for the holidays. There's a lot for everyone, a lot of different stuff, a lot of different acts, a lot of different shows for all genres.
Yeah, we got lucky this year. We had quite a bit of Christmas programming with TSO and then Mannheim Steamroller, obviously, and comedy has done very well this year. And then obviously the kids shows keep doing well, so they'll keep coming to town.
That's good. And before we go much too further, let me give the phone number for people, if somebody wants to call in. And I have a question for Royals Drew Bell or Dave, our general manager. Phone number 610-378-0426. We welcome your calls. And Dave, also Broadway show, our series has started up. And what ones do we have coming up in the future here?
We've got Broadway. This year we've got a Close to You, which is the music of the Carpenters.
Okay.
For a performance. And then we're going to have a special show announced in April, or a show in June that'll be announced in April that has to do with something blue.
Okay.
I can't give you the name, but hopefully everybody can pick it up from that.
Right, something blue. Okay. That's it.
And then obviously the Janis Joplin musical will be here.
Right.
This spring, which will be a great show.
Yeah, the Broadway shows do pretty good. They have a good following. There's some season ticket holders for that, and they seem to do well.
Yeah, we have subscription services for Broadway, and it's up and down every year. It depends on the lineup. This year, I think our lineup's pretty strong, so we should have a good year. Mannheim Steamroller falls into that kind of Broadway group as well.
That's good.
I'm not really familiar with Mannheim Steamroller. How do they differ from TSO?
It's pretty close.
They're close.
It's more of a symphony, where TSO is your rock,
right,
your rock musical. Mannheim's more of your classical symphony type music with Chip Davis playing keys and singing a little bit. So it's a great show. It's a good Christmas show. Their stage decoration is fantastic as far as the Christmas kind of ambiance. So it'll be a fun night.
Mm-hmm. That's good. Yeah, I know they're real close because people have said, oh, if you like one, you usually like the other. Mm-hmm. So that's always a good
show. Yeah, Mannheim's a little calmer without the fire and the pyro. So yeah. It's a great show, though.
It can be good or bad.
Yeah.
Depends on what you like.
It's good for the ice. The ice can recover without the pyro so much.
Yeah, the ice is tough.
Yeah.
The ice doesn't hold up too well when there's fireworks going
on. No, that's
off.
For sure.
I'm just being greedy.
Oh, we have a home viewer. So go ahead, home viewer. Welcome. Thanks for calling in.
Yes, I got a question for the manager of the Royals.
Yeah.
We haven't seemed to have a problem with our goalies here. When are we going to be getting some more goalies back again or whatever?
Oh, man. who am I talking with?
You're talking to Bob.
Hey, Bob. How you doing? Thanks for calling in, buddy. Goalies are an interesting breed, To have any interest in standing in front of a 100-mile-an-hour vulcanized rubber puck, you got to be a little crazy.
their play's been up and down, but I think we traded for a good backup. The Flyers and the Phantoms have had some injury problems, which has pulled some guys away. Martin Ouellette's been up since, I think, November 8th. He's been up in Lehigh Valley. He's not playing so many games up there because Anthony Stolarz has been playing so well. Connor Knapp was up there for the last week, and he came back and played exceptional for us this last Sunday and actually got us a win, got us out of that four-game slump. And Knapp played very well. So, it's an up-and-down thing. The goalies try their best always, and it really comes down to the team that's playing in front of them as well. I think Sunday, actually this weekend, in all three of our games, we showed a lot of good two-way hockey. I think the forwards are getting back into play a lot more. I think we saw that on Sunday. We were able to pull out the win.
It's always surprising how when one goalie gets hurt, it seems to snowball throughout the whole organization. And you lose a good goalie, and they go back and forth.
Thanks, Bob. I appreciate it. Do you have any other questions?
No, I'm good. Thank you.
I appreciate it.
Thank you for the call.
We were saying a little earlier, when you're at the bottom of the order, anybody gets hurt. If it's Michael Neuwirth that's been hurt, Steve Mason, LaBarbera's had an issue up in Lehigh Valley the last couple of weeks, we're always going to have people pulled from us. And, I've said it time and time again, and I'll say it. I'll say it again right now, the best asset that we have on our hockey ops side is our head coach and director of hockey ops, Larry Corville. He continues to pull rabbits out of hats and puts guys into places to succeed every game. And, this past Sunday was no different.
Larry's always been a good recruiter, always seems to find some diamonds in the rough each year. So hopefully this year with the goalie he just signed that he helps us out when the other goalies are pulled up.
Yeah, he does it every year. His recruiting is second to none. I think you see that with some of the young guys we have. Joe Raykamp, Justin Crandall, Mike Pereira. Mike Pereira and Justin Crandall are top five in scoring in the league right now, and they're both rookies.
And Crandall's been playing good, and he got the appendicitis.
He missed a week getting his appendix out. Same thing happened to Ryan Kreller's on the road last year. I guess it's a little bug for the Royals 2 years in a row. But, and then we just had
the food there.
Joe Raykamp just got a call up. It's actually his second year, I think, but he just got a call up and was signed to a PTO in Lehigh Valley, so we wish Joe nothing but the best. Hope he's successful there, but hope that we get somebody in return here soon.
We need some guys back.
Sure.
Dave, I wanted to talk about, we were talking a little bit about basketball before we went on here. Berks County playoffs are coming up. We have that. It's always a good night, especially the championship night with the girls and boys. Do you have the dates yet on those coming up?
The second week in March. I don't know the dates off the top of my head, but it's those. I think it's that Wednesday, Thursday, Saturday.
Okay.
Same as last year, the second week of March.
Okay. Yep. And that's always a good draw. I mean, especially when Randy High at Berks Catholic. I mean, we had like 6,000 people there last year.
We had a full house on Saturday, which was great.
And Randy brought their pep band, and it was an exciting night. It was it was a good crowd.
Yeah, it was a great night. It was a fun tournament all around. The girls' game was good, and the guys' game was really good with Reading playing in the finals.
Any chance, I know we talked a little bit about this also, but maybe get some district state playoff games? Because that kind of basketball seems to do well here.
We've been working hard to try to get some regional and districts and state basketball, and as long as wrestling and volleyball and hockey and all the high school sports. So we'll keep chugging along and see what we can get to come to town.
It's definitely a good competitive week for basketball.
Yeah.
I don't think it gets more competitive than the Royals Arena staff game, though. Over lunch. There's lots of elbows thrown there.
Oh, yeah.
You want to talk about injuries.
I know.
Yeah, we're always
especially
trying
to do the changeover.
Trying to get high school sports in the building, so we'll keep working.
They do draw well.
They draw well.
It's good for the community.
Yep, and I think having the Doubletree across the street that's going to open next week is going to be huge for that as well, to give us a close option for the teams to stay. So
Look forward to that.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm.
Drew, I know we talked about the December games, and we won't be on air till after the holidays, so want to talk about some of the January games, the early January games coming up?
Yeah, absolutely. We jump right back into it.
January's pretty full, so.
Yeah, January 2nd, we've got your Royals Resolution Night. It's Saturday, January 2nd. We're right back in Reading after our game on the 19th. Then the week after that, on the 9th, we've got our first Teacher Appreciation Night. We encourage students and teachers to come out, wear your school colors, and celebrate, cheer loud. We'll have specials for any student that shows up with a student ID that night. Then later in January, we've got two big games on the 22nd of January, which is our affiliation night. We'll have Bernie Perrant coming out. He'll be dropping the puck, signing autographs, taking pictures on the concourse.
Oh, Bernie Perrant, nice.
And we're going to have Lauren Hart coming out and singing before the puck drop as well. And anybody that likes the Flyers and follows the Flyers know how.
And she does a good job. When she does it at the arena,
she does a great job.
It gets the crowd pumped.
She does a great job. And I don't want to let the cat out of the bag completely, but it's going to be it'll be an intro anthem that everybody will enjoy, especially if you're a Flyers fan.
Nice. And what night is that again?
That's Friday, January 22nd.
Okay.
And the immediate next day, January 23rd, is one of the most important nights out of the entire season for me. That's our Penn State Thon night.
Okay.
We'll be wearing Penn State-themed jerseys. It's also our Wall of Honor induction night. We'll be inducting somebody that's very near and dear to my heart. We haven't made the announcement yet. We're still finalizing the details, but it'll be a great night. The jerseys will be auctioned off to benefit Penn State Berks County Thon. Which we all know raises money for pediatric cancer. It's that, I think, 48-hour dance-a-thon. It was important to me when I was at Penn State, and now that, even more so now that I have young kids of my own, just the thought of kids with cancer is, pretty tough to swallow, and anything we can do to raise money towards, eradicating that disease and finding a cure, we're all about it. So
it's good to see that the Royals and the arena are giving back to community with these events that we're holding, that bringing the community together.
Yeah.
We had the teddy bear toss.
We just had shelter night this past weekend, the first time we had specialty jerseys. We had Star Wars jerseys that we auctioned off that are going to raise money for the food bank and local homeless shelters as well. We also had a can drive to donate to the food bank as well. So we're very active in giving back to the community as much as we can.
Yeah, one thing we've started doing is with a group called Vet Ticks. We did it for Trans-Siberian Orchestra, Chris Young, and we're going to do it for a couple upcoming events. And really what you're doing is giving, there's a website, vetticks.com, and you're giving tickets to veterans and their families to come out and enjoy an event and have a good night. So that's something that we've been doing that's really, really cool. And
we're just jumping on board with it as well. So we're going to be giving out lots of tickets for vets and their families.
It's always good to give back to the vets because, they've given a lot to the country. So it's always, every little bit that we can give back to them, it means something.
Right.
Yep,
that's a nice thing.
Yeah.
So any final thoughts of stuff coming up for the season? For the Royals, what do you think our prospects for going down the road here is to get some players back, hopefully. What do you?
I think we'll be able to weather this storm. I think with all the injuries we've had, until we get guys coming back, we're going to be hovering at that cut line for playoffs. But I think when we get a lot of healthy guys back, that we'll be able to make a run. And if we get everybody healthy and a lot of guys back for the playoffs, I'm pretty confident in the long run. So we've got a lot of good things going on. We've got two big games in December. I encourage everybody to come out. We've got a jam-packed January, and then a little lighter load in February, but we're looking forward to getting the season going again.
And I know I was at the last game, it was out on Friday. Yannick Tiefu's back, and he's a fan favorite. And
Tiefu is back. We got Derek Mathers in the game. He's fighting every game, every chance he gets, and the fans in Berks County love that.
Yeah, they always did. Yeah,
it's a little bit like the Coliseum sometimes in there, and I love it. So it's good. We're excited.
That's good. And Dave, I know you're excited that the hotel is opening up. We touched on that a little bit.
Yeah, the hotel's going
to
open.
So I know you talked to their general manager over there hopefully do some combined events down the road.
Yeah, Craig and his staff are staying busy, getting ready to open up. Soft opening, I think, next week, and then the grand opening on the 14th. So excited to get that open and have an option for our guests to spend the night here in Reading after they enjoy a show at the Performing Arts Center or the arena.
That's good. Great. And I know we're going to touch a little more on our next show, but Jazz Fest is coming up. We do a lot of ticket selling for Jazz Fest, so do you want to...
Yep, Jazz Fest is going to go on sale this Saturday.
Oh, okay, well, already Saturday, so it's a good lead in there.
Yep, and they've got a good schedule this year, so it'll be an exciting
And we
time.
Do a lot of the selling for them, so that's always a good thing for the Jazz Fest.
The ticketing.
And our February show, we will be having John Ernesto on, general manager of the Jazz Fest, so we look forward to having him on in February. Well, I want to thank you guys again for coming out on this rainy night. Thanks, Dave. Thanks, Drew. Appreciate
you. Thanks for having us out.
And I want to thank the listeners and the viewers. And have a good holiday season, and thank you for watching tonight. Have a good night.
Merry Christmas.
Good holidays.
Merry Christmas.
Santander Arena Spotlight on BCTV is underwritten by the Berks County Convention Center Authority.